Tell me one thing. If something happens against your mind and it evokes your anger, or somebody is the reason for your anger, something really went wrong, you are completely furious. What do you do? How do you feel to react? And how do you react? Let's see what is this all about.
Hello everyone. Hope you are doing well by staying calm and positive. The last year was very topsy and turvy one. In that stressful situation, not getting angry, aggressive, unstable, was that possible? Is that possible now? Everyone would say that only superpower can make it real. And yes, it is not less than any superpower. Everyone has it. We just need to identify it, improve it, and maximize it. And that is nothing other than emotional intelligence. Let's see how does it matter to us and how we can implement it in a real life. Let's get started.
Let me make it more interesting for you. Do you remember a Kabir from Kabir Singh movie or the professor from Money Heist? Which person would you like to be? Kabir with high IQ and low EQ, or the professor with high IQ and a good EQ practitioner? It is our choice, because we can develop our own EQ and maximize it. Ultimately, people with high EQ have demonstrated their intelligence also. So basically, what is that making Kabir acts aggressive? Few more examples. So say, person who has fear of public speaking feels chills when he sees the crowd and stammers. When we expect any result, we experience butterflies in our stomach. Another example. You can relate to this. Imagine you are driving on a freeway. It's a holiday, sunny breezy morning, roads are clear, no traffic at all. And backseat, you have your family member, loved one, or a pet. Out of nowhere, another car speeds up and cuts you off. It comes just right in front of you. Way too close to your safety, life and death situation. What happens to our body? We gasp. We tightly hold the steering. Heart starts pumping. We react physically. Sometimes shake a fist at driver and say some bad censored words. Right? Why does this happen to us? Because emotional center and logical center of our brain have a war to decide our reactions. We may act emotionally before we act logically. So that's how we have to pause and allow our logical and emotional centers of our brain to have a convo, and we should utter a word or react logically. Also, we should know EQ hijacking. Say, you're working hard on a deadline. Several pings and tasks are being piled up. Addition to that, you are expected to attend a major client meeting. You have been distracted all day by several people, and one thing leads to another. The next person who pulls your trigger receives the full force of your fury. The first trigger, you do not like to work under deadline, and in addition, a chain of events unloads unfairly on someone else. Here, the brain shifts into a flight or fight mode, and thinking process gets shut down completely. So, that person may not even understand what exactly happened at that moment. It happens with everyone. In fact, every person carries different rocks of emotions in our sack. Let's see how to throw those rocks and act logically by developing EI. The first two significant stages are self-awareness and management. Let's list down what are those things, what triggers you and drives you nuts. Do you find these triggers resulting in feeling cold, racing heart, change in breathing speed or anger? It means you are already witnessing emotional hijacking. Now, observe your reactions, events, how your body language, the behavior is connected with emotions, and what are the behavioral patterns. Study how you have handled the situation before and how you would like to handle it next time. Practice it in daily routine. The next two important parts are social awareness and relationship management. Identify EQ around you. Observe people around you with high EQ and analyze how they manage it. Connect with people around you, understanding what people like or dislike and what they appreciate. Sometimes put yourself in other shoes and exercise a bath. That's it for a day. Don't control your emotions, but identify them. And yes, I'm not an expert, but a practitioner. And there is more to learn about EQ by experiencing and practicing it. Also, do refer the book Emotional Intelligence by Goleman to discover more about it. Toodles, stay calm and happy.